The fifth question. How was India benefited from the contribution of Sir Mokshamundam Vishwasaraya and M.S. Swaminathan in the fields of water engineering, agricultural science? See, here you have to mention the contribution of Vishwasaraya and Swaminathan, particularly in the fields of water engineering and agricultural science. And not only you should discuss about the contribution, but also mention how it benefited the India. So this is the important point here. See, most of us generally know about M.S. Swaminathan, as in our syllabus of agriculture, we know about the Green Revolution and its contributions. However, about Mokshamundam Vishwasaraya, very few of us know the famous works that he has done. However, those students who have read the newspapers on 15th September on the Engineers' Day, definitely they would have read about certain contributions of Vishwasaraya. That is why it is better that you don't stop reading the newspaper even the last few days of UPSC. As you know, this examination is on September 23rd and about Vishwasaraya it came on September 15th. So do not stop reading newspaper even in the last 10 days of the examination. Now, in this, see, as you start this question, first in the regard of Vishwasaraya, if you know any facts of Vishwasaraya, try to tell all of them in the one or two lines, in two or three lines, and then move on to his contribution to the water engineering. For example, you can say that Sir Mokshamundam Vishwasaraya is, you know, he was actually the Diwan of the Mysore state in the British India. He was a famous civil engineer who has extensively worked on the irrigation works, you know, construction of dams and several other water works. He, you know, also he was Bharat Ratna. He was given Bharat Ratna by the government of India, and also he was given knighthood by the British government. So after writing few facts like that, then come to some of the major projects that he has done in the water engineering. So one of them is the construction of, planning and construction of Krishna Raj Sagar Dam. See, this dam was built where Kaveri River and its tributaries are meeting. It was in the Mandya district, the region of the Mysore. It was actually a gravity dam that was planned by Vishwasaraya. See, after writing a few facts about the dam, you come to explain how it has benefited India. See, this Mandya district and the Mysore region was very dry and agriculture production was very less, and farmers there were very poor, and you know, the poverty, hunger are predominantly there in these areas. But after the construction of this dam, the reservoir actually highly helped in the irrigation of these areas, and these areas actually became agriculturally very rich. Thus, he is able to eliminate the hunger and poverty in these areas because of this dam. Not only this dam, he has constructed, planned, even he was consulted by the British government for several other dams, most of which actually helped India in the drought times. It actually helped in the navigation, irrigation and domestic needs of the water, also in the controlling of the floods. Now, another major project of Vishwasaraya was to make Hyderabad as a flood-proof city. See, Hyderabad mostly used to get floods from Musi and Isa rivers. And during that time, around 1908-1909, when the flood was approaching Hyderabad, Mokshamundam Vishwasaraya was called upon to, you know, reduce the impact of the floods on the city, and he has designed a network within the city where the floodwaters of Musi and Isa could not actually come and flood the city as it has done previously. And even today, the work which he has at that time is helping Hyderabad to remain as a flood-proof city. So even the present engineers can learn a lot from him. So thus, it has benefited the India. Similarly, another major work of Mokshamundam Vishwasaraya was flood gates, you know, the automatic floodgates. Automatic doors, you know, the wheels. Vishwasraya has actually designed and he has got a patent for automatic floodgates, automatic wheels. What happens is, when during the floods, the water level rises beyond the limit in the dam, previously they used to open the gates manually to let the water out. But after this invention, automatically the doors get open once the limit is reached. Now this was first tested and tried in 1903 in the reservoir in Pune. And it has given good results, because of which later on it is implemented in the Mandya and the Mysore region also. Now how it benefited India? See, because of this one, even if due to some reasons manually nobody is able to open the gates, automatically they get open and they release the excess water, because of which the dam would not collapse during the flood time and there won't be large scale destruction during the floods. The another major works of Vishwasraya that we remembered is Vishakhapatnam, you know, Vishakhapatnam seaport, Vishakhapatnam port. On the Vishakhapatnam port, the work of Vishwasraya actually helped in reducing the erosion and reducing the siltation of the beach. Even now, many people call it as a civil engineering marvel, which was done with, you know, in a low cost and in a very practical approach. So, these are some of the major water engineering works of Vishwasraya which benefited India. Now, let us move on to the next part of the question, Swaminathan. Well, this part I am sure most of you would have written very good answer for this part. M.S. Swaminathan is called the father of green revolution and he has actually revolutionized the yield of the most of the food grains in India. In 1965, see, till 1965, India used to import the food grains, and because of the green revolution, particularly his work on the plant genetics of wheat and rice, both varieties of Mexico for the wheat and variety of Philippines for the rice, actually helped India. It benefited India in achieving self-sufficiency in the food grains. It actually helped in reducing the poverty and hunger among the Indians. And see, for the first time, because of this plant genetics, the high yield variety seeds are able to reach even the simplest of the farmers. Thus, one of its greatest contribution is taking the science to the masses, to the rural areas. Taking the science to the rural masses. Nowadays, most of the farmers are using high yield seeds in a, you know, for a very low cost. Also, see, because of the green revolution, there were, as you know, some regional inequalities, and it actually degraded the soil. It was not sustainable for the ecosystem or environment. Also, it has used more chemicals that has caused health problems. That is why Dr. M.S. Swaminathan has actually worked on evergreen revolution. Evergreen revolution. In evergreen revolution, he tried to take the agricultural, you know, the high yield agriculture to the other parts of India, not only Punjab, Haryana, or, you know, Western UP, but also the eastern parts of India. And in this agricultural revolution, he tried to focus on conserving the biodiversity and keeping in mind the ecosystem and environment. And he tried to reduce the usage of the fertilizers. For example, methods like integrated nutrient and pest management, sustainable farming has been encouraged. And this actually benefited India in sustainable development, sustainable agriculture. Even the poor farmers can follow these methods. See, he actually focused on biotechnology in agriculture. Actually, initially it was only to the wheat and rice, but later on it has been extended to several other crops in India. So biotechnology nowadays has finding application in several crops of India, which is increasing the yield. In fact, because we are able to reduce the import of the food grains, we are able to conserve, you will say, our forex. That's how it benefited India. We are able to save our forex. The foreign exchange reserves. Also, Swaminathan is able to, you know, show the government the importance of spending on research development in agriculture. One of the institutes like ICRI Research, actually, their work, R&D work in agriculture, is helping India, particularly in the dry land farming. So here, see, either Vishweshwaraya or Swaminathan, towards the conclusion, you can write something about, you know, your opinion about them or how their contribution helped India in a very large scale. For example, you can say that both these great people are able to use the science for the benefit of society. So, using science for social development. Also, you can, you know, use Article 51A, the fundamental duty. One of them is, you know, developing the scientific temperament among all the Indians. And these two people, great people, actually contributed, you know, in a rationalism and developing the scientific temperament among the Indians. On that note, we can actually conclude this answer. For, you know, and then you have any other doubts? Any questions on this one?